Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Hi, how are you?
I'm fine, thanks. How are you?
Good, nice to meet you. What's the act called?
Charlotte and Jonathan.
Charlotte and Jonathan. Okay. How old are you both?
I'm 16.
And I'm 17.
Okay. And you thought the combination would work. Whose idea was it?
It was our singing teacher's, actually. She thought it'd be good to try us out together. And we both sounded quite good when we sang what we did.
Okay, you're not saying much, Jonathan. Are you shy?
Sometimes. I've always had sort of problems with my size since I can remember. And when I was in sort of primary school, it was back then really that I had sort of the mick taken out of me, and it kind of damaged my confidence quite a bit. When people would say something to me, it'd just take a little piece out of me in a sense.
I'm quite protective of Jonathan. Like, if I was there and someone stood there and said something to him, I couldn't sit there with my mouth shut. Before you make a judgment on someone, I think you really need to get to know them. It's not. As cliche as it's not judging a book by its cover, you've got to read what's inside.
Charlotte's been a really big help for me in terms of confidence and making me a better performer, and I really don't think I'd be going up on stage today if I didn't have Charlotte by my side.
And do you think you could win?
Yeah, together.
Yeah. All right, good luck.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Here we go.
That you can move an audience like that. You sing beautifully together. It was world class.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
A pop voice and an opera voice together. It was incredible. Okay, this is what I think. Charlotte, I think you're good, but Jonathan, you are unbelievable. You have an outstandingly good voice.
Thank you very much.
How old are you?
17.
I mean, that's unbelievable. Jonathan, you are a future star.
Thank
Thank you.
I like the fact that this works as a duo, but I worry, Charlotte, whether you're going to hold him back.
Well, we've come on here as a duo, and we're going to stay here as a duo.
Okay, David, we better vote, yes or no?
Ah, such an easy decision. Yes.
Thank you.
Definitely a yes from me.
Charlotte, I think your voice complements Jonathan's really well, so don't be disheartened. It's a yes from me.
You know, my head here would say to you, Jonathan, dump her. And then my heart would say there was something kind of magical at moments together as well. So I'm going to say yes to the two of you. You've got 4 yeses.
Well done! Well done,
Corbin. He's like eating Pavarotti, that boy. I haven't heard a voice like that in years.
No, to be that young and that good.
Simon's a massive fan of you, isn't he?
Seems like it, yeah.
That is the biggest response we've had today.
Well.
Oh, my God.
Oh. Well done, my pal. Do you think it could be life-changing?
Life-changing? Well, yeah, to be honest.
I think for you.
Yeah.
You're Callum, Jade's brother. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Oh, well, tell us a little bit about yourself, please.
I'm 26, I'm from Hull, and I'm singing a cover of a song by Robin.
I love Robin.
Yeah. It's Dancing on My Own, but it's a bit slower.
Okay, whenever you're ready, good luck.
Thank you.
Somebody said you got a new friend. And does she love you better than I can? And there's a big black sky over my town. I know where I bet she's around. Stilettos and broken bottles, I'm spinning around in circles, and I'm in the corner watching you kiss her. Oh, oh, oh. And I'm right over here, why can't you see me? Oh, oh, oh. And I'm giving it my all, but I'm not the guy. Far away, but still so near. The lights come on, the music dies, but you don't see me standing here. I just came to say goodbye. I'm in the corner watching you kiss her. Oh, and I'm giving it my all, but I'm not the guy.
Thank you.
the music dies, but you don't see me standing here.
Well done, Paul. Well done.
Thank you so much.
Oh my God, Simon!
Callum!
I've been singing ever since I was 4. I sing at school, I sing at home. I sometimes sing when I'm eating my dinner. I would like to be a singer and a diva. And I definitely want to be like Beyonce.
Good luck, little white mark. Good luck, have fun.
Hello, darling.
Hello.
Could you be any cuter?
What's your name and how old are you?
My name's Natalie and I'm 10 years old.
Okay. And what are you doing today?
Well, I'm going to sing a song called No One from Alicia Keys.
OK, yeah, I know that one.
Does she sing all the time?
Yes.
What, it drives you crazy?
Yes.
You've
yes.
had enough? Oh, so you're trying to palm her off on us now, is that what it is?
Good luck, darling.
Want you close, where you can stay forever. You can be sure that it will only get better. You and me together through the days and nights. I don't worry, 'cause everything's gonna be
get them on their feet.
No,
a little more clapping.
No.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Well, that's very nice of you to say. So what are your names, boys?
My name's Charlie.
And my name's DeAndre. And together we're Baz and Melody. Bam.
What's the dream with you two guys?
I just want to deliver it to you people. I just want to give an awesome performance.
I get ya. What does your mum and dad do for a job?
My mother's a personal trainer, and my father's a stonemason.
Stonemason!
Yeah, bro!
And you?
My mum's a cook in a school.
Dinner lady, yo!
And, my stepdad, he owns his own company.
He's a businessman, yeah!
Can I just say one thing? Alicia, I love you so much. You're my inspiration.
He fancy Alicia. He don't like Amanda.
Amanda, you're beautiful as well.
He is lying!
Boys, can I just ask you, what are you singing?
Well, it's Hope by Twista and Faith Evans, but it's a bit of a twist in the rap because I wrote it myself.
What's the song about?
It's about anti-bullying.
Anti-bullying?
Yeah, because it's something that I feel deep about, so... I started rapping because I went through a very hard time in primary school. I was getting bullied.
As a parent, it's one of the hardest things to see your child upset and going through emotional turmoil. It is hard, very hard.
When I used to be, like, down in the dump, I used to write down my raps. I could express myself through what I was writing down.
I was very happy with the way Leandre dealt with it. He actually stood up to the bully and resolved the situation.
I moved school and it's a much better environment for me. I love school. I really do love school, it's amazing.
I'm very proud of him, very proud.
The first time we met, we really clicked. It was just an automatic connection. Like, I didn't think it'd be like that.
We're brothers.
I think music's made him a lot stronger. If it wasn't for his music, he wouldn't be as confident and as cheeky, you know? It just helps him a lot.
We really want people to listen and hear our lyrics that are in our song.
OK, good luck.
Thank you. God, I feel so alone. I'm just a kid, how can I take it on my own? I'm crying too many tears, yeah, writing this song. Trying to fit in, where do I belong? I wake up every day, don't want to leave my home. My mama's asking me, but I'm always alone. Too scared to say, too scared to holler. I'm walking to school with sweat around my collar. I'm just a kid, I don't want no stress. My nerves are bad, my life's a mess. The name should call me, they hurt real bad. I want to tell my mom, she's having trouble with my dad. I feel so trapped, there's nowhere to turn. Come to school, don't want to fight, I want to learn. So please, Mr. Bully, tell him what I've done. You know I have no dad, I'm living with
just
my mom.
Hopeful, yes I am. Hopeful for today. Take this music and use it. Let it take you away.
I like these two.
I do. Hopeful, hopeful, and he'll make a way. I know it ain't easy, but that's okay, just be hopeful.
Why do you trip back a single day? I didn't ask to be born, but now I have to pay. I ain't got no money, you take all I have. When they give it to you, I search for my bags. I feel so scared when you shout me down. You kick me, punch me, throw me to the ground. When I ask you, yo, what have I done? You hit me again, I make fun of my mom.
I'm hopeful, yes I am.
Yeah.
Hopeful for today, take this music.
Check it out.
Use it, let it take you away. And be hopeful. Hopeful, and he'll make a way. I know it ain't easy, but that's okay, just be hopeful.
What I wear is all I have. No. We lost a home, I'm living from a bag. Yo, Mr. Bully, help me please. I'm flesh and blood, accept me please. Hey, Mr. Bully, I don't know what to do. My mind, I can't explain what I did to you. Mr. Bully, take a moment please. Every single day, you bring me to my knees.
Hopeful, yes I am. Hopeful for today. Take this music and use it. Let it take you away. And be hopeful, hopeful, and he'll make a way.
I know
it ain't easy, but that's okay. Just be hopeful.
Oh,
so much.
Seems like we hardly need to critique you, went so well, but let's have some comments. Amanda.
I'm just so happy for you. Your voice is beautiful. We all were in tears. So well done.
Thank you so much, thank you.
The minute you started that verse, it actually brought a tear to my eye. It was really, really moving.
Alicia, if it weren't for you, I wouldn't be rapping, so, yeah, thank you so much.
Oh, that's really sweet.
For two young kids like yourself to come out and sing about something that really affects you, do it in a style that's completely yours, is a really rare thing. That's why you got that golden buzzer today.
Thank you so much.
Well, you know what? I've heard some monstrous songs today and I just was literally losing the will to live. You know what? I listen to every word. Did this stuff happen in your life?
I got bullied a bit when I was younger, but...
But not anymore?
Yes, yeah, it's all gone now, yeah.
I think that record could be a hit, I really do. I really, really like you two.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
That's it, we'll see you in the live show.
Yes!
What's your name?
Darcy Oak.
Darcy, where are you from?
I'm from Canada.
Are you living in the UK or are you?
I'm not, no, I came here just for this. So.
How old are you, Darcy?
I'm 26.
And what got you into the act that you're doing today?
When I was a kid, actually, I had hopes and dreams of becoming a doctor, but my parents insisted that I become a magician. So, here I am. My name is Darcy Oak, I'm 26, and I specialize in sleight of hand and illusions. I've loved magic for forever. When I was a kid, my dad was messing around with cards. I pick one, he pulled it out, and it was my card. I experienced that feeling of like, how did you do that? And I wanted to do that to other people.
Now, say the magic words.
Abracadabra. Oh.
Thank you.
I'm auditioning for Britain's Got Talent because it's the biggest talent show in the world. And I want to be performing on a global scale. And I feel that if it goes well, it can change my life. I'm going to go out on that stage and I'm going to do what I've practiced my whole life. And hopefully they like it.
All right, wish you the best of luck.
Thank you very much.
I'm Paddy.
I'm Nico.
And what is the nature of your relationship?
It's a professional one.
And might we ask you your age?
I will be 80 this July.
Do you think you can win this show?
Oh, it would be very nice, but just as long as people enjoy what we're doing and we give people pleasure, that's the main thing.
Okay, well, best of luck. For what I did, because I did obviously buzz a little early. This is before all the crazy things happened, you know? It was all kind of like slow and normal, and then it all went ballistic. It was extraordinary.
You're an amazing example to older people, because you've shown that however old you are, you can still be spectacular and beautiful and do something amazing.
She can. All people can. If you want, you can.
How did you get into dancing?
I had been a dancer from the age of 2 and a half, like lots of little girls, and I gave it up to get married. I had 4 children.
Then when did you pick up dancing again?
I went to live in Spain with my husband, and unfortunately, after 18 months, he died. And for something to do, I went to Nico's Dance Academy to learn something totally different, and this is the result.
grandmother is 93 years old, and I just kept thinking of her when you were being thrown around that man. And I think she would have wanted me to press my buzzer for you as well. So me and my nan are going to be right behind you, and I hope you win Britain's Got Talent. That you did it for all those years and then had your lovely children, then lost your husband, you gave up so much.
Well, when I started to do this, I spoke with the family and I said, what do you think? And they said, well, you gave everything up to have us look after Dad, and he would be proud.
Yes, he would.
Paddy, you are my hero. Like, you are unbelievable. I pray to God that I am like you when I'm your age. I don't want to sound patronising, but we have to just say it as it is. That is something I've never seen before. I'm so pleased Amanda has pressed her button. And bravo, Nico!
And do you know what? We don't have to vote.
And if you have a minute,
how old are you, James?
I'm 24.
Is this what you do full-time, or do you have a day job?
This is now full-time for me. I've been doing it. It's a bit of magic since I was 8.
Simon loves magic.
I know how much he loves it.
I do like magic when it's good.
Okay.
Okay.
Best of luck.
Definitely going to say yes.
Four big fat yeses. Congratulations. Hello.
Hi.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent. What's your name?
My name's Shakarudin, but people call me Junior.
Junior.
Yeah.
How old are you, Junior?
I'm 17.
What are you going to do for us today?
I'm going to be dancing.
Okay. So what got you into dance?
Well, in the past, I've had some behavioural issues. And, like, I've been dancing, like, for a long time now.
Okay.
And it's really helped me grow as a person and get better, so. I'm really, really nervous today. This is, like, the biggest performance I'm ever gonna do. I've come a really long way. Now I have the chance to prove myself and show my family who I am. I've been waiting for this for a long time, and, like, I feel like it's a must. I have to do it. When I was at school, like, I used to struggle a lot with the work. I would feel like if I'm getting a bad grade, I can't do better. Like, I would just feel like I'm like a dumb kid or I'm just not smart enough. I felt like misbehaving was like the only option. I used to get in a lot of trouble, got excluded a few times. I was in a bad situation. When I started dancing, it actually gave me like so much confidence, and I got people praising me and saying good things about me rather than being in school and messing about. But like, I've been training every day, man. So like, hopefully like it all pays off. When I am dancing, I feel free. I can just like tell you a story, I can talk to you. Dancing has saved me from going down a completely different road. I can imagine if I wasn't dancing, like I don't know where I would be today.
Okay, good. The stage is yours.
Thank you.
feel right now? Is it overwhelming? Alicia, what did you think?
Do you know what? Usually that kind of thing cringes me out, but for some reason with you, it didn't at all. I couldn't take my eyes off of you. That was incredible.
Thank you.
I could see it in your eyes, what it meant to you, and all the negative things that you've obviously been through, you've now turned into a positive. It was an amazing, very different performance to anything we've seen before.
Thank you.
I have to tell you, it's one of the most incredible things I've ever seen on this show. I mean, seriously. You're going to be talked about after this performance, I'm telling you.
Thank you. I thought it was so brave of you to channel all your emotions and anger or feelings, whatever they might be, into a piece like that. And it really expands what we think dance can be. So it was incredible what you did. You should be very proud. Thank you. We're going to vote. And I'm going to kick this off with a yes.
Junior, it's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
And make that four yeses.
Good for him.
Junior.
That was tremendous.
Wow.
Well
done.
Was amazing.
Well done, come on here.
I thought that was really, like you said, he was very brave.
Yeah, it really meant a lot to him.
Yeah, definitely.
What a brilliant
thing.
Thank
you.
What's your name?
Asanda.
And how old are you?
11.
11 years old. Wow.
She's very cute.
Lovely.
Now, are you going to sing today?
Yes.
Who are the stars that you really look up to, you'd like to be like?
Beyonce.
I'm often compared to Beyonce.
I'm a little bit of a diva. I love listening to Beyonce and Rihanna. They're like my inspiration. Like Beyonce, when she's on stage, she brings such a fierce. Mm-hmm, girlfriend, you know what I'm talking about? Like, please. Music is everything to me. When I'm singing, I just feel magic.
Asanda sings around the house, she just cannot stop. Even sometimes when she does her homework, it's a struggle because I have to tell her, listen, it's not time for singing now, Asanda. It's time to do your homework.
If I got the chance to sing one of the Queen, maybe I could teach her how to have a little bit of an inner diva, and the Queen can teach me her posh accent.
Take it away, good luck.
Thank you.
Here we go.
Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond.
Oh, she's got some moves, hasn't she? She's got some moves.
You're a shooting star, I see a vision of ecstasy. When you hold me, I'm alive. You're like diamond in the sky. At first sight, I felt the energy of something. I saw the light inside your eyes. Tonight, we're in love. You're beautiful like diamond.
Thank you.
I cannot believe my eyes. You know, when you are on the money, your voice is incredible. Thank you. I can hear you on a record already, and you're 11 years old. You were like a little diamond. I'm lost for words.
I mean, I kept laughing because you're just like, it's just ridiculous. And you've got all the moves.
Sandra, you know, we've had a lot of people your age over the years performing. I've never seen anyone who's got such amazing stage presence for an 11-year-old.
Thank you.
I mean, seriously, seriously good. And you have the best smile I have ever seen.
Thank you.
We're going to vote. David, yes or no?
It was phenomenal. I'm going to say yes.
Thank you.
Good.
A massive yes from me.
Thank you.
Amanda?
It's a yes from me.
Cassandra? You have four big fat yeses. Yes! Yes!
Yes!
Come here. Well done. Where did that come from?
My parents.
Oh, well, I tell you, you've got two very proud parents behind you. She made. He was nearly crying, your dad behind me. And quite rightly.
Hold them.
Hold them back. Well, listen, how are you going to celebrate now?
Have McDonald's.
Yeah! I like the sound of that. Good girl.
Yay!
Good, how are you?
Oh, I'm so great.
What's your name?
I'm Lettuce, like the salad.
Lettuce.
My surname's Robotham. Like rowing, then boat, and ham.
I think you might be the poshest contestant we've ever had.
Oh, thank you.
On the show. And I think you're also the poshest person to ever come to Birmingham. I think so.
My name is Lettuce Rose Robotham. I am 24 years old and I live in Surrey. When I was four, my parents gave me a plastic violin and I was furious. I really wanted a real violin. Really did. When they gave me a real one, I just took to it like duck to water. I'm definitely not prepared. I listened to the track this morning in the car on the way here, which I probably shouldn't tell anyone, but I'm very honest. It'll be interesting to see what the judges think. Simon Cowell, very clever trap. He's got his fingers in so many pies. I'm too hungover to be nervous. Which I think is great.
So why are you here today?
Because I would love to share my thing, talent, if it is, I don't know, with more people and make more people happy, hopefully.
Well, Lettuce, we're intrigued.
Are you?
Whenever you're ready, Lettuce, okay. Robotham.
Lettuce, Robotham. Cool.
Yeah?
Yeah.